This video is brought to you by mywayteaching.com.
In this part, we are going to see the position time graph for motion with positive acceleration, negative acceleration, and zero acceleration. So as I told you before, if the curve is upward, then it represents what? Yes, it represents positive acceleration. You can see in this first figure, that is figure A. And if the curve is downwards, then it represents negative acceleration, isn't it? And that is represented in this figure B. And if the curve is straight line, then it represents zero acceleration, isn't it? So here, the acceleration is zero. So all these three cases are represented using the position time graphs. So now let us see some of these simple cases for velocity time graph. So in this part, we are going to see the velocity time graph for motions with constant acceleration. Or else we can say we are going to see the velocity time graphs for some of the simple cases. The first case, this figure, the velocity time graph as of this figure A, it represents an object is moving in a positive direction with a positive acceleration. So if I write graph like this, the object is moving in positive direction with positive acceleration. For this, we can consider the motion of car between t is equal to 0 seconds to t is equal to 10 seconds. Here the car is picking up the speed, so it is moving in positive direction with positive acceleration, isn't it? So this is the first velocity. So we saw that velocity time graph example of that car. So what about this second case? Yes, this second case represents an object which is moving in a positive direction but with a negative acceleration. So it is moving in positive direction but the acceleration is decreasing, so with negative acceleration. For example, again we can consider the same car example at different time interval. So here we can consider from 18 to 20 second. Okay, 18 to 20 second, it is moving in positive direction but in negative acceleration. Okay, let us consider the third case. Here an object is moving in negative direction with negative acceleration. Okay, for example, the motion of a car moving from O, as we can, from point O in the negative x direction, it is moving with increasing speed. So here it is an example for the third case, that is an object is moving in negative direction with negative acceleration. Okay. And the last case you can see here, an object is moving in positive direction till time t1. So from here to here, the object is moving with positive. The object is moving in positive direction, isn't it? But from t1, so and then it turns back with the same negative acceleration. From t1 again it moves with negative acceleration. For example, we can see in this figure the motion of a car from point O to point Q, isn't it? From point O to point Q, that is till time t1, we can say, with decreasing speed, and again it is turning back and moving with the same negative acceleration. from point O to point Q, it is up to time T1 with the decreasing speed, and again it moves back from point Q, it moves back and it moves with same negative acceleration. So this is the example. An interesting feature of this velocity time graph is the area under this velocity time graph, it gives displacement over a given time interval. Okay. So we can see that in the next figure. So here we can see the area under V by Vt curve, it gives the, yes, it gives the displacement. So the Vt curve is a straight line parallel to the time axis, isn't it? This is a straight line parallel to this time axis. We can see in this figure. The area under it between t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t. Between t is equal to 0, which means from this point to t is equal to t, from up to this point. Okay. It is the area of the rectangle of height u and the base is t. Therefore, area is given by area is given by that height u into base t. Okay. That is given by u into t, which is the displacement in this particular time interval. How come in this case an area is equal to distance? Just think, how is that possible? It is, you just see the dimensions of quantities on the two coordinate axes. Then you can say how this, the area under this Vt graph gives the displacement. Okay. Moving to the next part. That is kinematic equations for uniformly accelerated motion. Okay. For uniformly accelerated motion, we can derive some simple equations that relate displacement x, time taken t, initial velocity as well as final velocity and acceleration. Okay. We already got one relation in the previous case, that is V is equal to V naught plus AT, isn't it? This one we know. This relation is graphically represented by this figure. You can see, okay. The area under this curve is given by so here the area under this curve is given by area between the instants 0 and t, that is area of triangle. This from 0 to this t, that is area of this triangle ABC, plus area of rectangle OACD, isn't it? So this area of this triangle ABC is given by half into height is V minus V naught and the base is T. Okay. And area of rectangle is given by V naught into T. You can see this, right? Yeah. Length into breadth. So we already know this equation, isn't it? V minus V is equal to V naught plus AT. We know this. It is already derived. And we can write V minus V naught as 80. Can we? Yes. And therefore, this x will become 1 by 2. Instead of this V naught by minus Vt, we can substitute with this 80. 80 and one more 80. 80 square plus V naught into t. So, x is equal to V naught into t plus 1 by 2 at square. So we can write this as x is equal to V plus V naught by 2 into t. Okay, that can be written as V bar into t, where V bar is given by what? Yes, V bar is nothing but V plus V naught by 2. So we can write this x as V plus V naught by 2 into t, isn't it? And that V plus V naught by 2, we can represent it using V bar. So these equations, that is equation x is equal to V plus V naught, this equation we'll call it as 1 and this one as 2. So these equation 1 and 2, they mean that the object has undergone displacement x with an average velocity equal to the arithmetic average of the initial and final velocities. Okay. And then from the equation, that is V is equal to V naught plus AT, from this we can get the value of T, isn't it? Yes. So V is equal to V naught plus AT, we know. So here we will take the value of T. That T is given by what? Yes, that is given by V minus V naught by A. So now we'll substitute this value of T in equation that we derived just now. That is X is equal to V plus V naught by 2 into t. So this can be written as V plus V naught by 2 into V minus V naught by A. So this t is replaced with this value. So we can write it as A plus B into A minus B. We know A square minus B square. So by 2a, isn't it? So we can write this as V square. V square is equal to V naught square plus 2ax. This equation can also be obtained by substituting the value of t in equation. We can also obtain the same result by substituting this value of t in equation x is equal to V naught into t plus half into at square. We also got this equation, isn't it? If you substitute the value of t, we'll get the same result. Okay, connecting five quantities V naught, V, A, T and x. So this equation, it connects five different quantities, isn't it? These are kinematic equations of rectilinear motion for constant acceleration. Okay, the equations that we got now, like the first one is V is equal to V naught plus AT, isn't it? And even x is equal to v naught into t plus half a t square. And even v square is equal to v naught square plus 2ax. So these equations, they connect five different quantities like v naught, v, a, t and x, isn't it? So these are nothing but kinematic equations of rectilinear motion for constant acceleration. We can also obtain a more general equation if we take the position coordinate at t is equal to 0 as non-zero, say x naught. Then the equations can be written as in a more general way, if we take the position of the particle or the position coordinate at t is equal to 0 as non-zero, say x naught, okay, then we can write v is equal to v naught plus a t, x is equal to x naught plus v naught into t plus half a t square, and v square is equal to v naught square plus 2a into